change policy in the context of the Federation in a federalism. So the topic of presentation is here, climate change and Indian federalism, a study with special reference to national action plan and climate change. So let me begin with the very first thing, that is NAPCC, National Action Plan on Climate Change. This is the first policy document which came into being in 2008, and this is the first time that serious action has been taken from the Indian side in addressing the very debated and discussed topic, that is climate change. So I would like to give a brief outline about my presentation today. So first I will begin with introduction. Then climate change in India during the past century. Then climate change in Indian federal setup. I'll be giving more focus on national action plan on climate change, and then some selected case studies from the state point of view, that is state action plan on climate change and how states are implementing and all. Then some policy actions, the current state of the play. And then certain objectives and key findings. And finally, I'll go for the recommendations. So, the purpose of the presentation. So, the main emphasis of this study is to assess the issue of climate change in Indian federal setup. How the issue of climate change is taking place at the state level, at the national level, and at the local level. And while I'm talking about the Indian Federation, so that time, I'm linking climate change or environmental matters, climate change more particularly environmental matters in more general. How the Indian Constitution is addressing the issues and which article of the Indian Constitution or which provision, which category is linking towards the issues of climate change. Then I will focus on 2008 scenario and post 2008 scenario with an eye on the National Action Plan and State Action Plan. Here I am talking about four things. First is, the study is to assess climate change issue in Indian federal setup and how the role of the constituent units of federalism in adapting and mitigating the issues of climate change. There are actually two, adaptation and mitigation, two parts of climate change. I don't want to find the exact way. Adaptation and mitigation, I will clarify both of them. Mitigation means mitigate or to limit or to reduce the emission level. We know that climate change is a hot topic and it is one of the debated in the very recent times, and we can't totally stop climate change, but we can reduce to a certain extent. So when we are talking about reduction of climate change, that's in that time we are talking about mitigation part, and the other is adaptation part. Adaptation part means to adapt to the changes, that is to use sustainable agriculture, to use solar power, to use wind power. So these things are coming under this adaptation part. So I will come later in more detail. So next is, I already mentioned that the National Action Plan on Climate Change, the 2008 scenario and post 2008 scenario. Then how certain organizations or institutions like Finance Commission and NITI Aayog, they are dealing with this. Then while investigating to this issue, at this federal level, I'd also like to focus on certain central institutions and their impacts on this particular aspect. Then the role of the states, how central states are dealing with this issue. So let me begin with this very fast introduction of climate change. We know that climate change is a continuous process and it can't be stopped totally, but we can reduce to a certain extent or partially we can reduce. We know that, I've already mentioned here, that how much average temperature increase, just think of 2030, 2050 and 2080, even three parameters here. I've taken two case studies in Kashmir and in Karnataka. In Kashmir, we know that it's one of the coldest places in India. And the case of Rajasthan is just opposite of Kashmir. So how the uncertainty and how this effect affecting to both the cases. So here, rise in maximum and minimum or entire distribution of temperature. You see, here more hot days, less cold days. These are the impacts of climate change. In India, we can particularly find, not only in India, but every part of the world is facing this problem, but I'm talking about India here, more particularly, that in India, in summer it is severe, but in winter it is not that much severe, I mean not that much cold or colder. Just two case studies here. One is Rajasthan. The impact of climate change, how it is affecting here. In case it is affecting, so it will affect first in Rajasthan, we will find more hot days, but not in Kashmir. In Kashmir we need actually little bit hotter, but in Rajasthan we need a little bit softer, I mean not that much. And another is, more rain will be good in Rajasthan but not in Meghalaya. But what actually is going on, but just opposite of this. So how the changes of climate change from 1880s to 2000, this is the changes in the 20th century, the temperatures. The first is, the World Bank 2002, the updates are not available. The government of India in 2004, it says that 0.4 degrees Celsius, this is the average increase of temperature. Then Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change, IPCC, 2007, it found 0.68% of Celsius of temperature. Then in government of, then in 2004 again, the government of India, it finally it addressed that warming mainly in the post monsoon and winter seasons, and it is predominantly due to the increased maximum temperatures. And there has been a significant warming trend along the west coast in central India, the interior peninsula, and the west northeast India. So these are certain things that we need to look at. Here, in this diagram, we can find here, in 1880s, the temperature was around 0.2 degrees Celsius. And in 2000, it is around near about 1.0 degrees Celsius. So there has been sharp increase in the temperature day to day life because of so many things like transportation, industrialization. So these things are responsible for this. Then how, the main topic. We'll go to the main context of this topic, that is climate change in Indian federal sector. When we are talking about in Indian federal sector, we can find there are three things. National level, state level, and local level. In national level, we know very well that the National Action Plan on Climate Change, this is the past policy document, and this is the, you can say, this is the policy. After 2008, there has been a lot of research on climate change in Indian context, because from Indian side, by the government side, very seriously, the attempt has been taken during that time. Previously, there were a lot of international negotiations, like Kyoto Protocol, UNFCCC, and so many. But in 2008, for the first time in India, we found that the issue of climate change had to be addressed by the constitutional mechanisms, by the policy form, or by the government initiatives. So that was the result. In state level, after the initiation of National Action Plan on Climate Change, almost all the states are now adopted. They have already adopted the state action plan. But it is, we have to see whether there is any gap between the theory and practice. We know that the states are also adopting climate change measures, how to reduce the emissions level, both means of adaptation and mitigation. So, let me talk about the National Action Plan on Climate Change and certain strategies. The very first is, this National Action on Climate Change, it underscores for the first time that the need for specific planned interventions to enable communities to develop adaptation measures to greater climatic vulnerabilities. There is no mention about quantum of resources required for 8 missions implementation, including co-adaptation missions. I will talk about these 8 missions later on. Next is complete silence over rolling out of mission at national, sub-national and local levels and its deliveries. Then several states have already mentioned that almost all the states have now adopted this climate change policy. These eight methods are national solar mission, national mission for enhanced energy efficiency, then national mission on sustainable habitat, national water mission, national mission for sustaining the Himalayan glaciers and ecosystems, the there's no mission for a green India, then there's no mission for sustainable agriculture, there's no mission on strategic knowledge for climate change. So these eight, these 8 points can be said that the eight pillars of the National Action Plan on Climate Change, which was established in 2008. So on the basis of these eight, the policy is actually going on. There are certain key strategies. I've taken two case studies referring to the State National Plan on Climate Change. One is Madhya Pradesh and another is Uttar Pradesh. So first, let me begin with Madhya Pradesh. Certain key strategies to MP State Action Plan on Climate Change. Here what I found, I'm taking adaptation strategy very fast. The changing natural resource management practices. How it emphasizes? It emphasizes some certain things like new or repair natural resource management practices. For example, managing water, land, protected areas, fisheries for adaptation strategies. Because these are also linking to climate change. When we're talking about the environment, we have to look at the environmental practices. There are certain things which are directly or indirectly affecting to this climate change. So climate change is a broad concept. Next is building institutions. By building institutions, it creates new or strengthens existing institutions. For example, establishing committees, identifying mechanisms for sharing information across, then institutional boundaries, across the boundaries, then training staff responsible for policy development. Then certain planning processes, that's already launched. Like sets of motions, a specific process for adaptation strategies. For example, developing a disaster preparedness plan. There's only early awareness program, early warning system. So these are coming under this disaster preparedness plan. Then convening stakeholders around vulnerability assessment finance. The next is raising awareness. I've already mentioned that it raises stakeholders' awareness of climate change, specific climate change impact, and how it is affecting. So people should have certain knowledge. They should get some awareness program. And it is also becoming out of the day. We can say it's a hot topic in newspaper, in TV, in media, in every aspect of our lives, they are finding climate change every day. I think a day without climate change, the newspaper is not filled. Every day we are finding certain environmental issues, climate change, and so on and so forth. So next is promoting technology change. How technology promotes. Here it says that it promotes implementations or development of technology new to the location. For example, irrigation technology, communication technology. Next is establishing monitoring and early warning system, already mentioned. Next is changing agriculture forest utilization practices, then empowering people, promoting policy change, improving infrastructure, providing social protection and all. Next is the case study of Uttar Pradesh State Action Plan on Climate Change. Here, but I count. This is more or less same thing, but slightly different. I took both the states because in terms of population, in terms of area, we were talking about MP and UP, both are coming at a commandable position. So, promotion of natural regeneration and mixed species forestry, then prevention of fragmentation of forest and linking of protected areas, then sustainable harvesting of timber and non-timber products, anticipated plantings of species across latitudinal and longitudinal gradients and prevention of fire. Then state water mission is another very good, it's a mission which addresses the issues of climate change. It mainly talks about in promoting saving of water and efficiency use, then enhancement of observational infrastructures, policy change and other changes. The next is state action plan. State action under the missions of sustainable agriculture. It also encourages for direct sowing system like agricultural products and agro-sciences, the sustainable habitat mission, the state missions for sustaining the Himalayan ecosystem. So how the distribution of power between central and states is actually happening in relation to the environmental matters, more particularly talking about the climate change aspect. Here, the union or the center, you can find the center is having residual powers, whatever we are talking about in a federal system. That then certain factors are coming under the central aspect. Those are atomic energy, mineral resources, then interstate rivers and river valleys, certain ports, then regulations and development of oil fields, minerals, oil resources, petroleum products, and health of those liquids. Under state part, you can find public health, sanitation, hospitals, dispensaries, these things are coming there, communication part, road, business, and land, waterways, and these things are coming. And other things like land, water, agriculture, the fisheries, so these things are coming under when we are talking about the distribution between the center and the states. So, the findings, what are the key findings? So, here I found that the adaptation which we are talking about, the certain agriculture, or the solar system, or wind energy, or biomass. So, these plants are already formulated, but these plants are not properly coming in an effective way. Because we know that there is a lot of difference between the theory and practice. Public policy is a complex system, we have already studied. It takes a longer time, there are so many processes are there. So adaptation is yet to be recognized as a policy priority by the government. The next is states as crediting units have to be mainstreamed in national climate making policy. Most of the times you can find the relationship between a particular state and center is different from that of the other state. So that also matters a lot. If we are talking about Kerala, and if you compare to a northern state, northeast state, you can find a difference because of awareness, because of education, because of so many factors that are affecting this. So that should be a proper balance between the same between the center and the states, so that the address, so that the issue can be addressed properly. The next is development and funding those central sponsored schemes and central schemes and central assistance to states. This should be linked to the state level of climate change adaptation and mitigation. There is also need for a scope of the local, at the local level, like you can say at the district level or at the block level, because democracy should begin from the village. When we are talking about at a mass scale, we are neglecting certain factors of certain communities or certain section of the people. Last is, there is no clarity with regard to the sources of funding for implementing state action plan on climate change. We have already studied and we also know that the NITI Aayog, the Finance Commission, they all are working. But how they are working? This is also a matter to understand. There are certain recommendations. So, how to deal with this? The first, there is a need of focus on implementing the state action plan on climate change. Then still, once it then allocate budgets, involvement of multiple stakeholders in exercise external data. Then budgetary composition should change in the favor of greater priority for adaptation measures. This is what I found from our budget. Then next is policy focus should be so to bring environmental concerns at the center of climate change discussions at all levels of the planning, budgeting and implementation. Then there is a need to limit the greenhouse gas emissions and improve the energy security. So India is a developing country, we know very well, and we have to maintain a balance between what we are having and what the sources we are having and how to stop or how to control out of that. So in economics we studied that we have limited resources, but we have to satisfy all the wants within these limited resources. So we have to find which is very important and which is possible. So the best alternative we have to find. Then need to focus on both adaptation and mitigation strategies. So I've already mentioned adaptation and mitigation strategies. And the very recent, not recent, just one of all, I think, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal, he formulated one policy or even policy that was working for very few days. But that was also a part. Kind of good type of policy that is helping in mitigating to certain extent, because the emission level can be checked. But I don't know whether it is possible all over the world, all over the country or not. The next is it will be act sooner rather than later. We have to act sooner because the process is going up and it's very difficult to control unless and until the developing countries and developing countries just join hands together and we can all be very successful.